Good morning, friends, and welcome to the pre-market view. We had a very smart pullback in the US markets on the back of good economic data points. Both consumer sentiment and the GDP data that came out from US were better than expectations, and the markets had a very smart pullback. Even European markets were up anywhere from about 1 to almost about 1.5%. And when we look at the Asian markets today morning, Nikkei is marginally up, but the rest of the markets are subdued. And SDX Nifty is suggesting that we are going to open down about 25 to 30 odd points. Back home, we had a very smart pullback in the last 2 hours of trading session on Friday on the back of a revision on outlook by S&P to stable from negative. And the pullback was quite broad-based, but is not backed by the FI flows. So in terms of flows, the FIs were net sellers in the cash market to the tune of 1,134 crore. And the domestic institutions were buyers to the tune of almost about 1,100 odd crore. And in the index futures, we have seen selling of about 219 crore. And in the stock futures, surprisingly, the selling was almost about 2,100 odd crore. So last 4 to 5 trading sessions, we have seen that the dollar index is inching up and has crossed 85.5 mark. And the FI flows have been negative, though we have seen some kind of a relief in the sense that the domestic institutions have been buyers, but overall the flow picture is not looking too encouraging. On that note, let me invite Sadhana to take us through FNOQs and important ideas that we can have from the FNO desk.
Good morning, friends. Let's have a view on derivatives. In Friday's trade, we have seen that the Indian benchmark indices continue to trade very volatile. But in last 1 hour of trade, we have seen a smart recovery backed by gains in many of the blue chip counters across with all sectors, due to which Nifty snapped its session at 8032 levels with a marginal gain of 0.75%. On the first day of the series, we have seen that long positions were built up by market players as open interest increased by 4% from 1 crore 65 lakhs to 1 crore 72 lakhs. Approximately 14,500 contracts were added in Nifty futures. Also, Nifty futures price increased by approximately 60 rupees. On the other hand, cost of carry also increased by 7% from 7.90% to 8.49%, and Nifty futures premium increased from 60 points to 63 odd levels. Indiabix was down by 2.78%, which was decreased from 13.30 to 12.93%. In the options activity, we are seeing that call option 8,000, 8,100, 8,200 has seen good build up. Like, we have seen good short positions were built up at higher levels, and 7,800, 7,700 put option has seen marginal addition in open interest front. There is no security in bank period today, and FIs were net sellers of 363 crores in future and option segment. They were net sellers of 230 crore in index futures. They were net buyers of 777 crore in index options. They were net sellers of 1,004 crores in stock futures, and they were net buyers of 78 crore in stock options. Our Friday's VWAP still stands at 8110. Lower range for the market would be 7950, and higher range would be 8110. Singapore Nifty is down by 35 points, which is at 7887. So we may see 7950 might act as a strong support going forward, and we may see flattish to negative start in Nifty futures today. That's it from derivatives. Thank you.
Friends, let me take you through Sher Khan, a pre-market action report starting with actionable ideas. And the first one that we have is JP Associates. There's a short call as the Competition Commission has ordered a fresh probe against JP Associates for alleged unfair business practices. So one can short JP with a stop loss of 28.5 and a target of 425 to 23. The next one is Asian Paints. We have a long call here as the Karnataka cabinet on Friday has approved the transferring of 55 acres of land to the KIADB to be allocated to Asian Paints. So that's a big positive for Asian Paints. One can go long there with a stop loss of 620 and a target of about 642 to about 655. Anand Raj, again some positive news as the company has announced the sale of its wholly owned subsidiary Gateway Estates for almost about 304 crore. So one can go long on Anand Raj with stop loss of 53 and a target of about 57 to about 59. And Polaris, finally they have set a record date for the demerger of the product business and the services business. So one can go long on Polaris with a stop loss of 257 and a target of about 272 to about 280. Here is a watch list for the clients who want to go long or short for the day. Positive buyers are JSW Energy, Kotak Bank and Rainbaxy, and the stocks with negative buyers are ITC and Reliance Infra. In other news, GMR will set up a convention center near the Rajiv Gandhi International Airport in Delhi at a cost of about 750 odd crore, and the West Bengal government has waived the penalty on Wipro's delayed payment of the 50 acre land allocated to it, so bit of a positive for Wipro. And the Fertilizer Ministry has moved a cabinet note for providing a financial package of 1000 crore for the ailing public sector firm FACT. And real estate major DLF has come under the scanner of the Central Revenue Officials for evading the service tax to the tune of about 30 crore. And Patel Engineering is planning to generate cash and reduce the debt by almost about 1000 crore by selling of non-core assets. And in other updates, National Aluminium Company NALCO looking at setting up a 100 megawatt wind power project with an investment of about 660 crore. And it is also contemplating moving a review petition in the Supreme Court for reconsideration of the decision to cancel allotment of a coal block to that particular PSU. And S&P has upgraded the outlook on certain institutions like Bank of India, HDFC Bank, ICICI Bank, IDBI Bank, Indian Bank, IDFC, Kotak, Mahindra Bank, State Bank of India, Union Bank, etc. The negative rating outlook on the Syndicate Bank and IOB definitely continues, which is a negative for these two banks in particular. And foreign portfolio investors can now purchase 100% of the TD Power system under the portfolio investment scheme. So a positive for that particular company. That's it from all of us, friends. Have a great trading session. See you tomorrow at the same time.